Hello, everyone. I'm Ido Green, and I'm developer advocate.
And I'm Danny Hermes, developer programs engineer, working on the cloud app engine. And we're here to show you our demo, which yesterday it was an offline demo. It actually never wanted to come online. So
we need this one connected.
If you want to see the full talk, check out the link at the bottom of this video. The talk was mobile web and the cloud, the triple crown of modern applications. And so here we go, onto the demo. Let's jump onto the device. Let's see it, Ido.
Great. So we have here a modern web, mobile web application. And first thing we need just to authenticate our users. So we'll sign in with G+, which is extremely easy, and you can check the code on GitHub. I'm accepting the confirmation dialog here. And now when I'm back, you could see a few things. One, the sign-in button vanished. And the app itself now made a connection to the server and brought us all the nice pictures that we took beforehand. Now, as you can see, I have here this crucial functionality to add photos. And here natively in the browser, I can just click on take photo. And very nicely, I'll try to give you a view of what we are seeing. And you could see that the photo were loaded. I can just give it a name.
Yeah.
Google.
Great photo of the studio we're filming in.
GDL. And I can save it. Now, when I'm saving it, a few things happen in the background. First thing, and the most important one, is that we got a confirmation first that the photo itself was saved locally, and then we got a confirmation that the photo was sent to the cloud to our one source of truth that we want to have there so we could see it on different devices.
Yeah. So if we switch to the laptop, where our wonderful user Wadsworth Testington has already signed in, and I refresh this page, we wait a little bit, and we actually see that photo there on another device. So heading back to the device.
Right. Now let's take it to the next level. As we spoke yesterday, we want to make sure that our app will be productive and could let the user work when we don't have any connection or we have flaky connections. So here I'll do something quite brave and just remember that we are in a browser. I'm just now releasing the connection, and you could see up on the top left corner that we have the offline indicator, and we are now offline. And I can still go, add a photo, take another nice photo of our studio here, and a few things will happen now. So I capture the photo, I can give it a quick name and a quick description, and save it. Now, when I'm saving it right now, you could see that I'll get confirmation immediately that the photo itself is now saved locally.
But if we switch over to the laptop,
the magic will happen.
And we try to refresh, we will see we don't have the photo yet.
Right.
But if we go back.
Now, let's go back to the tablet. And you could see that then once I'm switching and hooking it back and giving it a connection, first you'll see the indicator on the top changing from red to green and ready. And now our photo, oops, it's being sent to the cloud.
Sent to the cloud. So if we check out one last time on Wadsworth Testington's laptop, we refresh it and we wait a bit, we actually got that connection back and we see it. So that concludes our demo. Thank you for stopping here. Again, I encourage you to go see the whole talk, but chances are you actually came here from the original talk. So. I hope you enjoyed this, and we hope you'll check out some of the other videos from Google I.O.
Absolutely. And check in the latest and greatest in html5rock.com and built amazing web apps. Thank you.